Since 1960, Britain's population has risen by 21%, but the amount of litter we drop has gone up by a staggering 500%. Have people become so lazy they no longer know what a bin is? I decided to go to central London to find out more about the issue and how people felt about it.
At all, really, because it's sort of just making like the place you live dirty for everyone else.
Each year, England drops over 30 million tons of litter onto the streets. It's estimated that to clean it all up, it costs taxpayers £885 million each year. Fast food restaurant packaging is one of the biggest contributors to litter. Also, a major issue is people who smoke and throw their cigarette butts on the floor, despite bins often being close by. Chewing gum covers the pavements in almost every city, staining the streets and difficult to remove. In many residential areas and parks, dogfowl is all too commonly left behind by the owners.
On my particular street, what I get annoyed at is dog mess, is people not caring too much about where they live, just to get rid of this dog mess. That's one of the major things for me, personally, anyhow.
In cities, litter attracts animals, such as pigeons, seagulls, rats and foxes. Dropping litter in the UK is a crime, fineable between £50 and £80.
I wouldn't know what would happen if I got a fine, I'd probably be a bit annoyed.
A recent survey concluded that people feel safer in a clean area and less safe in one full of litter.
Yeah, because the environment, when you see an environment that is clean, that is tidy, it makes your brain think you are safe.
Surely then, all of these issues could be erased if people took the time to put stuff in the bin. It would make everything better, right? But then again, where does all the litter and bins actually end up? These landfill sites are filled with waste from houses and streets, industrial waste and construction sites. Despite being smaller, England dumps and buries more waste than either Spain, Italy or France. The sites release greenhouse gases and toxic liquid, which causes damage to plants and wildlife. Of course, the real solution to the litter on our streets is to recycle. Up to 60% of the rubbish that ends up in the bin could be recycled. For example, glass is 100% recyclable. Therefore, if all this litter from the street and houses that could be recycled was recycled, it would cut the amount of domestic waste going to landfill in half. I decided enough was enough. I had to make a stand and go out and promote recycling in my town.
So, it turns out that putting up posters is both illegal and littering, so we're going to have to go get them back.
Hopefully one day we can be a zero waste economy, where we reduce, reuse and recycle all we can, and throwing things away is a last resort.